السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وبعد. Today is Saturday and today's date is the 3rd of Sha'ban. It is Sha'ban, يا أخوان. The 3rd of Sha'ban for the year 1433 of the Hijra of the migration our great beloved Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, which coincides with the 22nd of June for the year 2012. And since we mentioned Sha'ban, so Ramadan is basically next. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast most of Sha'ban and sometimes all of Sha'ban. So please do so to the best of your sincere ability. Next, today in Khutbat al-Jum'ah, we spoke about how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam treated and dealt with his worst sworn enemies, those who were, after killing him, killing his religion, killing his followers. They persecuted him like no other persecution. They were in charge of Mecca. They were in charge of Al-Kaaba. How did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam treated them? And we mentioned the verse in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are not dependent on our feelings, especially nationalistic or nationalism feelings. Yeah. And why I'm talking about that? Because one of you showed me some letter he received from a colleague saying that he is not willing to work for such and such company, and they referred his reference to some of those modern scholars who says that the Muslims must boycott America and the American products because they support Israel. First of all, I do not know of any country under the sun, of any country, starting with Egypt, who does not support Israel directly and what under the sun, these things. Nobody gives financial aid to Israel. If you want to talk about that, then Egypt. Egypt is the major supplier of natural gas to what? Israel. And what? With fair market value or gifts? Gifts. So between oil and gas, forget about anything else, they give Israel every single year for the last, since 1979, $5 billion. America gives them what? Total $8 billion a year. Okay, so there is no such country. No such country whatsoever. And you notice now when they start falling around, everybody said, well, if we go, who is going to protect Israel? Al-Qaddafi said so, what's his name, Adel Jahsh al-Nafi Suriya said so, and so on, and so so forth. So this notion doesn't hold. However, if you think that boycotting certain product or certain country will help and you are doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is fine. But do these things. And they tell you, you cannot go and pray in Masjid al-Aqsa because it is under the occupation. Well, what was Sulh al-Hudaybiyah all about? What was all of Sulh al-Hudaybiyah and Hudaybiyah truce all about? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going to go where? To do his Umrah. And the Kaaba was under which occupation? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And so on and so forth. So, ya akhwa, if you are not familiar with the fundamental basics of your religion, anyone can sell you anything. His emotions, his feelings, his views, his agenda, and call it what? In the name of Islam, and you will buy it. Okay? So, let me share with you something else. Because ya akhwa, if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam was about to eliminate Quraysh and their allies, I'm talking about food-wise, forget about anything else, he would have done so. Yeah? And I'm going to share with you this hadith. But before I do, there is this, see ya akhwa, the difference now. Okay? The difference is between being sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your feelings are controlled by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you are following your feelings and controlling the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accommodate your feelings. That's the big difference between the Sunni Muslim, and I do not mean against Shi'i, the Sunni Muslim, the person who believes in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, loves him, and he does not accept anything except the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah? Look what Allah says. He says, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ اَدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ السَّيِّئَةِ نَحْنُ أَعْلَمْ بِمَا يَصِفُونَ. Rebel by means of what is best. What is best? Huh? We are most known of what they describe. So if we want to describe it, to destroy them, we would have destroyed them long time ago. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَنْ تَسْرَ مِنْهُمْ وَلَكِنْ لِيَبْلُوا بَعْضُكُمْ بِبَعْضٍ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose or willed, He would what? Defeated them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended is what? To test you by them, and by them by what? By you. You think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't know what's going on? He does not, in no time, in no place, in no function, destroy them? He can, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقُلْ رَبِّ, notice what's next. وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. And say, my Lord, I seek refuge in you from the incitements of the devils, the evil promotings. وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ أَن يَحْضِرُونَ. And I seek refuge in you, my Lord, least they present with me. Yeah? Some people when said, what? Allahumma ahdi America al-Islam, Allahumma ahdi Israel al-Islam, said, ya khalif tadu lahum. هذا أقل حقهم علينا. إذا لقيت الله سبحانه وتعالى راح تقول لله عز وجل. ها؟ يعني إنسان رمضان, maybe you heard me sometimes said what? اللهم أهدي إلى أمريكا إلى الإسلام, اللهم أهدي بهم إلى الإسلام. Said why you are praying for them? يا الله. Said why you are praying for the Americans to be Muslims? What sense we lost? What sense? ها؟ Aren't we supposed to pray even for Iblis al-La'in to become a Muslim? What is your function on earth? Your function, ya akh, was two things. First, you yourself to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second, to the best of your ability to call the others to what? To the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no da'wah, no invitation without what? Dua. Dua for yourself, for sincerity and the best ability, and dua for your success, and dua for them to accept. Yeah? But when you lose your senses, the Islamic senses, that's it. Everything will become what? Strange. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam by Umar ibn al-Khattab. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, give aid to al-Islam by guiding Umar ibn al-Khattab. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Yesterday he was an enemy, now he is what? The champion. What more do you want? وَكَفَى اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الْقِتَالِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the believers from fighting. Yeah? So, people, they start what? Thinking that, ya Allah, give this kafir hidayah, ya Allah, give this Yahudi hidayah, ya Allah, give this Christian hidayah. Said, why you are doing so? It became what? So strange. But he forgets that you have to. At least this is what you have to do. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the hidayah, the guidance to Al-Islam, for everyone. For everyone, this is the least. If you cannot give the da'wah, at least the du'a. At least the du'a. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in another surah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And who is better in speech than one who invites to Allah. Invites to Allah and does righteousness and say, indeed, I am of the Muslims. Extreme pride in Islam. Yeah? Then says Allah, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ ادفع بالتي هي احسن فاذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوه كانه ولي حميد. حميم best treatment يا اخوه. In most cases it brings best results. Even with your enemy. Allah says what? And not equal are the good deed and the bad. Rebel evil by that deed which is better. And there upon the one whom between you and him enmity will become as though he is a very what? Yeah. You know what's hamim? Hamim literally. وَسُقُوا مَاءً حَمِيمًا. Yeah. Anybody knows what's hamim? مَاءً حَمِيم.
Very hot.
Very hot. The very hot. العرب قل يسأل الحميم الذي غلي حتى توقف عن الغليان. Yeah? The one who boiled and does not boil anymore, it is becoming very hot. So he becomes what? Very warm. Yeah? Friend. Yeah? وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. But none is granted it except those who are patient, and none is granted it except one having a great portion of good. Again, وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه هو السميع العليم. And if there comes to you from Shaitan an evil suggestion, then seek refuge in Allah. Indeed, he is the hearing, the knowing. Those verses were revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was fighting the whole world. I'm so sorry. While the whole world was fighting him. Yeah? It doesn't mean that when your enemy is fighting you, you do not try your best to rebel the enmity with the best option. Because fighting, ya ukhwa, yeah? In Islam is the last option. The last, very last. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we read in Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim and others, said what? لا تتمنوا لقاء العدو. واسألوا الله العافية. فإذا لقيتموهم فاثبتوا واعلموا أن الجنة تحت إيش؟ ظلال السيوف. He said, do not wish to meet your enemy. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for peace. However, when you meet them, stand what? Firm. And know that Al-Jannah, paradise, is waiting under the shade of what? The swords. When you have to fight, you have to fight. The fight is over. The end of the story. The end of the story. Now, this hadith, I'm going to read. It's in Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, and everywhere else that you can imagine. Imam Abu Hatim, Ibn Hibban, look what he said after him watching this hadith. He said, قال أبو حاتم رضي الله عنه في هذا الخبر دليل على إباحة التجارة إلى دور الحرب لأهل الورع. He said, in this hadith, an evidence that it is allowed to trade, do business in the land of those who declared war against the Muslims, as long as you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب إمام البيهقي under the title باب بيع الطعام في دار الحرب. Subtitle selling the food in the land of what? Of those who declared war at the Muslims, who are fighting the Muslims. And this incident, all of you know it because we studied it several times. The hadith that is known, hadith, Thimam ibn Uthala. Thimam ibn Uthala al-Hanafi, rahimahu, radiyallahu anhu. Thimam ibn Uthala al-Hanafi, radiyallahu anhu. He was a sworn enemy to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he was captured, he was already what? His hands full of what? Of the blood of the Muslims. And he was what? He was the chief of not any town, of Al-Yamama. Al-Yamama, ya akhwa, was literally, as you heard the term is this, the what? The wheat basket of the Arabian Peninsula. The wheat basin. If there is enough or no wheat, there is no bread. Literally, like America today. Tomorrow they were not going to produce enough wheat. Half of the population will die out of hunger, and the other half will die out of what they are eating. Yeah. So, look at the nice treatment, and look how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam treats his worst enemy. It reads, and I'm reading from Sahih Bukhari. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال بعث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خيلا قبل نجد. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه said what? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم sent horsemen, a troop toward what? The district of Najd. فجاءت برجل من بني حنيفة يقال له ثمامة ابن أثال. And they captured one. They waited for him there. When he showed up, they captured him. Okay? Look now at the treatment. Sent him to another country for torture. Secret prison somewhere. The Muslims, they do not even know such feelings. They are not supposed even to exist in your heart. There is no personal enmity between a Muslim when he is calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala between anyone. You are doing it for the sake of Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. They accept it, alhamdulillah. They do not accept it, alhamdulillah. They receive you with the embracing hands or they spit in your face, alhamdulillah. Doesn't matter. So they captured him. So they captured a man from what? From the tribe of Hanifa with the name Thumam ibn Uthal. And in Sahih Muslim, فَجَاءَتْ بِرَجُلٍ يُقَالُ لَهُ ثُمَامَةُ ibn Uthal al-Hanafi سَيِّدُ أَهْلِ الْيَمَنِ. He said, and they brought a man by the name Thumam ibn Uthal al-Hanafi, who is what? The chief in command of أهل اليمامة. فربطوه بسارية من سوار المسجد. And they tied him to a column of the columns of what? Of the masjid. فخرج إليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال ما عندك يا ثمامة. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came to see him. Said what? What do you have to say يا ثمامة? فقال عندي خير يا محمد. I do not have anything but good things, O Muhammad. إن تقتلني تقتل ذا دم. If you kill me, I am already what? Your blood, the Muslim's blood already is what? On mine. Okay? I am as guilty as what? As charged. وَإِن تُنْعِمْ تُنْعِمْ عَلَى شَاكِرْ. And if you bestow your favor, you should know that the one who is about to receive the favor, referring to himself, is a grateful what? Man, I do not forget it. وَإِن كُنْتَ تُرِيدُ الْمَالَ فَسَلْ مِنْهُ مَا شَئْتَ. And if you want money to ransom myself, ask as much as you want. فَتُرِكَ حَتَّى كَانَ الْغَدْ. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم left him for the next what? Day. ثُمَّ قَالَ لَهُ مَا عِنْدَكَ يَا ثُمَامَ. The next day said to him, what do you have to say, يَا ثُمَامَ? Same thing. قال ما قلت لك. What I have is what I told you earlier. إن تنعم تنعم على شاكر. If you bestow a favor, the recipient is what is a grateful. فتركه حتى كان بعد الغد. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم left him and came the third day. قال ما عندك يا ثمامة. What do you have, O ثمامة? فقال عندي ما قلت لك. And he said to him, what I have is what I told you. فقال أطلقوا ثمامة. He left him in the masjid 3 days. So whatever, whatever disinformation he had, it will be what cleared by observing what? Al-Masjid. And the Ukhwa, Al-Masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people, they think it was just a place of prayer. It was everything. Everything. That was their secret room for everything. Everything used to be conducted where? In the Masjid. The room of the operation is the Masjid. The Masjid is the Masjid. For the Salah, for the Siyah, for everything, it was what? The Masjid. So he left him for 3 days, tell him, well, let's see what you heard and what you are going to see. So on the third day, he said, what? Free Thumama. فانطلق إلى نخل قريب من المسجد. So he what? He ran into what? A bush of what? Of palm trees that near to al-masjid, so he can find what? A cover for himself. فاغتسل ثم دخل المسجد. And he bathed there, then he came and entered al-masjid. فقال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. And he said, what? I testify openly that there is no God but Allah. And I testify openly that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And he proceeded to see. Ya Muhammad, O Muhammad. And this sentence you are going to hear. So many people after the good treatment said so. He said, Ya Muhammad. والله ما كان على الأرض وجه أبغض إلي من وجهك. Said, oh Muhammad, I swear by Allah, no face on the surface of this earth was more hated to me than your face. فقد أصبح وجهك أحب الوجوه إلي. And this morning, your face became the most beloved face to me. والله ما كان من دين أبغض إلي من دينك. I swear by Allah. Because this Thumama was, as you're going to see, was a very religious man. Religious, although he's a mushrik. He said, والله ما كان من دين أبغض إلي من دينك. I swear by Allah that there was no religion more hated by me than what? Than your religion. I hated no religion more than I hated your religion. فأصبح دينك أحب الدين إلي. And this morning, your religion became the most beloved religion to me. والله ما كان من بلد أبغض إلي من بلدك. I swear by Allah that no, I never hated any town more than I hated what? Yours, your town. فأصبح بلدك أحب البلاد إلي. And your town now, this morning, your town became what? Dearest to me. وإن خيلك أخذتني وأنا أريد العمرة. And your horsemen captured me in my way to where? To perform the عمرة. فماذا ترى؟ فبشره. وفي رواية فعلمه وبشره. He said, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him the good news, and they are going to see what's the good news. And the other narration said what? He taught him how to make the umrah now, and he gave him the good news. فبشره رسولullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam وأمره أن يعتمر. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him the good news. He taught him and commanded him to continue in his way and make the umrah. فلما قدم مكة قال له قائلا صبوت. See, if don't tell him, well, these are our enemy and Masjid al-Haram is under occupation. You are going to spend a few dollars there and they're going to help their economy. Yeah. Don't go there. Yeah. So tell him, proceed. Yeah. Because such relations, the akhwa, never cease to exist for a single what? Moment. Yeah. So when he arrived in Mecca, قال له قائلا صبقت. He said, well, when he arrived in Mecca, some of them, the news already what? Arrived there. Someone told him what? You have what? What they call it? Sabaut. In a way that you became fooled a cult. Okay? You fooled what? Not a religion, but what? A cult. You know what's a cult? Religion and cult, which doesn't have much difference outside of Islam, but yeah, all of them are cults anyway. Yeah? قال لا. He said, no. ولكني أسلمت مع محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. But I have submitted to Allah in Islam with Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. ولا والله لا يأتيكم من اليمامة حبة حنطة حتى يأذن فيها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And I swear by Allah, from now on, not one single grain of wheat will come to you from Al-Yamama until it is what? Approved by who? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. End of the story. And people, they said, well, is he able alone to do that? Well, if you know the mentality of the Arab, he's the chief, he's the chief. Yeah? There is no second argument. Yeah? Wallahi, I met when my grandfather was living with us. We were living with him, sorry. Yeah? Whatever he goes, it doesn't matter. Okay, you are up, down, left, right. That's it. It is final. Yeah? That's why they never needed what? A government ever, the only people under the sun that they never had what? A government. Never. Why? Because the system that they created, they believed in and lived by. Yeah? And he said, from now on, there is this thing. In Musnad Imam Ahmad, Qala Umar. In the narration of Imam Ahmad, and the chain of narration is sahih, is fawi, authentic. Qala Umar radiyallahu anhu. Umar radiyallahu anhu, at that moment said, لقد كان والله في عيني أصغر من الخنزير. He said, this chief of Al-Yamama, before this moment, he was in my sight, in my eye, smaller than a pig. يعني I appreciated, respected the pig more than I respected what? Him. وَإِنَّهُ فِي عَيْنِي أَعْظَمُ مِنَ الْجَبَلِ. And he said, now he is in my eye, greater than a mountain. خَلَّى عَنْهُ فَأَتَى الْيَمَامَ. So when he, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, released him, it's still Umar talking. He left to Al-Yamama, حَبَسَ عَنْهُمْ, and he what? Told him, no more exporting what? Wheat to Al-Yamama. That's it. فَضَجُّوا وَدَجَرُوا again. فَكَتَبُوا تَأْمُرُ بِالصِّلَةِ قَالَ وَكَتَبَ إِلَيْهِ. So they became what? فَضَجُّوا وَدَجِرُوا. And they have became what? So angry. And they became so tight. And we're going to read some of these things. So they wrote to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we thought that you command to be kind and dutiful to your kinship. This is how you do to your kinship? You are going to starve us to death? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wrote to the man and said, well, resume. Yeah? In the narration, of Imam al-Bayhaqi, he says, Thumama is talking now. He said, Thumama radiallahu anhu, Ibn Uthal al-Hanafi, وَإِنِّي أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. And I testify openly that there is no true God but Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is his abd, his slave and messenger. Ya Rasulallah, O Allah's messenger, إِنِّي كُنْتُ قَدْ خَرَجْتُ مُعْتَمِرًا وَأَنَا عَلَى دِينِ قَوْمِي. Said, Ya Rasulallah, when I was captured, I was in my way to make Umrah, while I was what? A follower of the religion of my people, i.e. Muslim. فَبَشَّرْنِي صلى الله عليك في عمرتي. So يا رسول الله, tell me about my Umrah. فبشره وعلمه. So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him the good news, and he told him what? He taught him. فخرج معتمرا, and he left in his what? In his way to perform the Umrah. فلما قدم مكة وسمعته قريش يتكلم بأمر محمد من الإسلام. And when he arrived Mecca, and Quraysh heard him talking about the affair of Muhammad and about Islam, and that he became a Muslim, قالوا صبع ثمامة. He said, well, ثمامة changed his religion and what? Became a follower of a cult. فأغضبوا. And they made him angry. They insulted his wisdom. Yeah? No chief of any tribe at that time was not what? The most wise among his people. Yeah? It was not a flip a coin. Yeah? Just because he was born to this family. Yeah? فأغضبوه. فقال إني والله ما صبوت. He said, so they made him angry when they made this statement. He said, I swear by Allah that I did not become a cult follower. ولكني أسلمت وصدقت محمدا وآمنت به. But rather I submitted to Allah in an Islam and I believed Muhammad. I believed Muhammad and I believed in Muhammad to be the messenger of Allah. وأيم الله وأيم الذي نفسي وأيم الذي نفس ثمامة ثمامة بيدي. I swear by the one whom the soul, the ruh of Thumama in his own hand. لا يأتيكم حبة من اليمامة. And not a single grain will come to from اليمامة. وكانت ريف مكة. And it used to be what? The farming town of who? Of Mecca. The food basket of Mecca. ما بقيت. As long as I live, حتى يأذن فيها محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Unless Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم himself, the one you do not like, he's my friend now. Until he gives what? The approval. It's not to me, it's not to this one. It has to be approved by the chief in command, Sayyidina Muhammad. وانصرف إلى بلده. Then he returned to اليمامة ومنع الحملة إلى مكة حتى جهدت قريش. And he stopped the export of the grain to Mecca until what? Quraysh was exhausted. On the brink of starvation. On the brink of starvation. Because it is the same story now. If you are the country that does not produce its own food, it's not going to exist. So until they reached what? They were exhausted until they are about to what? Reach the point of what? Breaking. فكتبوا إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they wrote to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يسألونه بأرحامهم. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام. So they wrote to him, said, well, we are asking you just because we are your family. We are your tribal people. We are your family and people. We are your brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles. Now, mashallah, now they are relatives. Yeah? أن يكتب إلى ثمامة يخلي إليهم حمل الطعام. Yeah? And what? So asking him, well, in the name of the kinship, yeah, to write to ثمامة, to what? To resume what? The export of الطعام. Because يا أخوة, the wheat, the word الطعام, although in the Arabic, it includes all the food, but الطعام originally, if you see the dictionary, it's mainly about what? About القمح البر, yeah, which is the wheat. ففعل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم did just that. Nowadays, Muhammad is wrong. He is aiding the enemy. Yeah? Directly or indirectly, willingly or unwillingly, knowingly or being very ignorant. This is the case. Yeah? Rasulullah could end it there. That's it. But what message that the common person is going to give? What is my fault? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is stopping me from eating. What's the message? Yeah? What's the message? Okay, we all died. They became Muslims? They did not. Yeah? That's why, ya akhwa, because of this good treatments, as we study in the seerah, yeah? That the whole Arab, they were waiting for Quraysh, Mecca to be conquered, to embrace what? To embrace the Islam. They were afraid of the bully. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسِ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجْ. And you saw the people entering, not forced to enter, entering in what? In waves after waves, waves after waves. Then look at this Musannaf Abdul Razzaq. Okay? It says, and the chain of narration is authentic, same chain of narration in Sahih Bukhari. And of course, Imam al-Bukhari reports from Abd al-Razzaq through his shuyukh a lot. And Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu anna thumamat al-hanafi usam. Fakana al-Nabiyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaghdu ilayh. And said what? Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu said what? That Thumama al-Hanafi was captured and became a prisoner of war. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to visit him in the morning. Fayaqul, ma indaka ya thumama? Ya Thumama, and he said, Yara, what do you have to say, Ya Thumama? We read that until he said what? It says what? وَكَانَ أَصْحَابُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يُحِبُّونَ الْفِدَاءَ. And the companions of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, they were in the opinion that he should not be killed, and if anything else, he should be ransomed. وَيَقُولُونَ مَا نَصْنَعُ بِقَتْلِ هَذَا. What benefits we are going to get from killing such a thing? Such a thing. Yeah? Such a thing. فَمَرَّ عَلَيْهِ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ يَوْمًا. And one day Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم passed by him. فَحَلَّهُ. And he released him. And of course, you know the story. He went and this things. And when he came back, look, this is the part. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ لَقَدْ حَسُنَ إِسْلَامُ. Listen to the last word. His hands are still wet with the blood of the Muslims. And it's not only Muslim. These are the elite of the early companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said what? لَقَدْ حَسُنَ إِسْلَامُ أَخِيكُمْ. In a matter of what? 30 minutes. He said, when Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saw him coming back, he said, what? Indeed, the Islam of your brothers is what? Is genuine. Your brother. He called him what? A brother. Immediately. Sahaba said, what's wrong with Ya Rasulullah? He's just guilty as sin. He's a brother now with all rights and duties?
Yes, he is.
You like it, you like it. You not like it? Well, jump over a cliff. Yeah? Jump over a cliff. Yeah? Is it time for adhan? Let's call the adhan, and if we have some other time, we share another story, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, of such wonderful stories. Go ahead, Habib. Let's resume quickly. We have 8 minutes left. Hopefully, we can cover as much as we can. In Sahih al-Bukhari again, and in the book of Al-Wakala, Al-Wakala literally translated what? The power of attorney. What is the power of attorney? You give a legal authorization to a person to represent you in general or in what? Specific task. And the title, Baba Idha Wakkala al-Muslim Harbiyan fi Dar al-Harb or fi Dar al-Islam. Said what? If a Muslim gives a power of attorney to a person who is a citizen of the country that declared war against the Muslims, or he gave him an authority to this citizen, in the land of Islam, it is what? It is lawful. And of course, you know that we studied this in a seerah many times, but quickly. And Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiallahu anhu qal, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, may Allah be pleased with him, said, Katabtu Umayyah ibn Khalaf kitaba. I wrote an agreement or a power of attorney between me and Umayyah ibn Khalaf. And you know who's Umayyah ibn Khalaf? Who was torturing who most?
Bilal.
Bilal radiyallahu anhu. بأن يحفظني في صاغيتي بمكة وأحفظه في صاغيتي بالمدينة. So he can protect my interest in Mecca and I'll protect his interest where? In المدينة. عبد الرحمن بن عوف تريتر. فلما ذكرت الرحمن and when I mentioned my name عبد الرحمن قال لا أعرف الرحمن. What is this? I do not recognize الرحمن. كاتبني باسمك الذي كان في الجاهلية. He said, well, write in this document your name that your name which you used to have during what? The era of الجاهلية. فكاتبته عبد عمرو. And I wrote it down as he wished, عبد عمرو. فلما كان في يوم بدر. And on the day of the battle of Badr, خرجت إلى جبل لأحرزه حين نام الناس. And he said, what? I went to a mountain to protect him when the people what? Went to sleep. فأبصره بلال. And who saw him? بلال رضي الله عنه. فخرج حتى وقف على مجلس من الأنصار فقال أمية بن خلف لا نجوت إن نجا أمية. And so he went to a gathering of الأنصار and said, guess who I just saw? أمية بن خلف. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى not save me if I let what? Let أمية be saved. فخرج معه فريق من الأنصار في آثارنا. So a group of الأنصار, a team of الأنصار, along with Bilal, came running after what? After us. فلما خشيت أن يلحقونا خلفت لهم ابنه لأشغلهم فقتلوه. So when I was afraid they are going to catch for us, I let go of his what? His son. So he was but caught. This is the akhwa in the midst of the battle. Don't think that these things. This is in the midst of what? Of the battle. So I released his what son. So he was captured and killed. ثم أبوا حتى يتبعونا. And that was not sufficient for them. They insisted on following us. وكان رجلا ثقيلا. And he was a heavy man. Really heavy man. Okay. فلما أدركونا and when they caught us, قلت له uprooted فبرك. So I told him what? Kneel down. And he knelt down. فألقيت عليه نفسي لأمنعه. So I threw myself on top of him to protect what? To protect him. I.e. secret service agent. Yeah? فتخللوه بالسيوف من تحت حتى قتلوه. So they what? From underneath me, they reached with their swords to him until he killed him. وأصاب أحدهم رجلي بسيفه. And in the process, some of them injured my what? My leg with his sword. وكان عبد الرحمن بن عوف يرينا ذلك الأثر في ظهر قدمه. And عبد الرحمن بن عوف used to show us what? The scar of that stab in his what? In his foot. Okay? Now, back to Sulh al-Hudaybiyah. This narration in many sources, authentic narration. Look, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, then he came back next year to do Sulh al-Hudaybiyah. Listen carefully. An Ibn Abbas, I'm reading from Sunan ibn Sirat ibn Hisham, and the chain of narration is what? Is sahih, is hasan. An Ibn Abbas, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تزوج ميمونة بنت الحارث في سفره ذلك وهو حرام وكان الذي زوجها إياها زوجه إياها العباس بن عبد المطلب. He said that ابن عباس رضي الله عنه said that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى وسلم married ميمونة in his trip to do the Umrah, and the one who was her guardian is who? العباس بن عبد المطلب is uncle. قال ابن إسحاق فأقام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بمكة ثلاثة. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم according to the what, to the agreement, he remained in Mecca for what? 3 days. فأتاه حويطب ابن عبد العزة ابن أبي قيس, the whole name but seven names I have. So حويطب بن عبد العزة came to him on the third day. في نفر من قريش في اليوم الثالث. This man came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in a delegation of Quraysh on the third day. وكانت قريش قد وكلته. Quraysh gave him the authority to speak to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. بإخراج رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من مكة to go and ask Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم what? The 3 days are over, leave مكة. فقالوا له إنه قد انقضى أجلك. And they said to him, well, your time is up. فخرج عنا. Said, well, leave us. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وما عليكم لو تركتموني فأعرست بين أظهركم وصنعنا لكم طعاما فحضرتموه. قالوا لا حاجة لنا في طعامك فاخرج عنا. He said, I just get married. What about if you allow me to consummate my marriage while I'm among them? And inshallah رب العالمين, I will have what? A walima, an invitation, and you will be my guests. Said, well, we have no need for your food, just get out. Yeah? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فخرج رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وخلف أبا رافع مولاه على ميمونة حتى أتاه بها بصرف فبنى بها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هنالك ثم انصرف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى المدينة في ذي الحجة. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم left, and he left Aba Rafi', his freed slave, to accompany Maymuna, and he brought her to him in a place called Sarf. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم consummated the marriage there. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم left to المدينة in the month of ذي الحجة. In the month of ذي الحجة. Quickly, inshallah, but give me just 5 more minutes, inshallah. Please forgive me. Quickly. This is in reading from Sunan Abi Dawood and the chain of narration meeting the conditions of Imam Muslim. An Jabir ibn Abdullah, listen. An Jabir ibn Abdullah, anna rajulan qama yawm al-fath. Jabir ibn Abdullah, رضي الله عنه, said what? A man stood up on the day of the conquest of Mecca. فقال يا رسول الله, and said, يا رسول الله, إني نذرت لله إن فتح الله عليك مكة أن أصلي في بيت المقدس ركعتين. I vowed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows you to conquer Mecca, to go and pray two rak'as in what? In Bayt al-Maqdis. Yeah. And people said, well, what is this and that? Because at that time, the Roman Empire, as we studied, you remember when we studied Tabuk, with their Christian allies, especially Al-Fasasina, they were gathering where? In that area to come attack what? Al-Madina. So they were what, in full declaration of war against what? Against Islam. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم صلي هاهنا. He said, well, why do not just fulfill your nadhr, your vow, by praying what? Here. ثم عاد عليه. But he kept what? Asking him. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم صلي هاهنا. So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, well, just go ahead and pray here. ثم عاد عليه. He said, well, but my vow was there. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم شأنك شأنك إذن. He said, well, if you insist, then go ahead. It's up to you. Yeah, it's up to you. In Sahih Bukhari, Tabuk under the title, this is my title from my own writing. Tabuk آخر المعارك في آخر حياة المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. The battle of Tabuk is the last battle and was in the last or in the later time of the battle of the life of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And you know the whole story of Ka'b ibn Malik and the other two men who stayed behind. And I'm reading in Sahih Bukhari. You know that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he heard that the Roman Empire and their what allies, they were assembling in what is called Jordan now, to come and what? March to Al-Madina. Yeah? And this is in Sahih Bukhari, it's not a fairy tale. Yeah? So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, well, before they come to us, let's go to them. And you know the story of Ghazwat Tabuk, the battle of what? Al-Usra, the hardship. And it says, just the quote I need. عن عبد الرحمن بن عبد الله بن كعب بن مالك أن عبد الله بن كعب بن مالك وكان قائد كعب من بنيه حين عمي. It says on the authority of Abdullah ibn Ka'b ibn Malik, who used to be the guide of Ka'b ibn Malik from among his children when he became blind. Who became blind? Ka'b ibn Malik رضي الله عنه. قال سمعت ابن مالك سمعت كعب ابن مالك يحدث حين تخلف عن قصة تبوك. I heard Ka'b ibn Malik, my father, telling us about his story when he what stayed behind and did not join in the battle of Tabuk. قال كعب ولم أتخلف عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في غزوة غزاها إلا في غزوة تبوك. And كعب بن مالك رضي الله عنه سدوات I did not stay behind رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in any غزوة, in any battle except the battle of Tabuk. قال listen, and you know that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded the Muslim community to what? To totally boycott them, not even assalamu alaykum. Yeah. Now look, listen, he just finished with the book, okay? And listen, قال كعب بن مالك فبينما أنا أمشي بسوق المدينة. كعب بن مالك, when he was very depressed, very distressed, he said, while I was walking in the market of Al-Madina, إذا نبطي من أنباط أهل الشام. And who was there facing me? A Nabati, which is the Nabati, it means what? The farmer, the one who Nabati, يعني يخرج الماء من الأرض west. A farmer from the what? From the farmers of what? الشام. ممن قدم بالطعام يبيعه بالمدينة. Who brought ta'am, food, to sell it where? In Al-Madina. From the same land that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم went to fight the battle of Tabuk. يقول من يدل على كعب بن مالك. And he was saying, who can lead me to كعب بن مالك. فطفق الناس يشيرون إليه. So the people told him, this is the man, here you go, that's كعب بن مالك.
حتى إذا جاءني دفع إلي كتابا من ملك غسان.
So he was not just a trader, he was also what? A spy. So when he arrived at me, he handed me a letter from the king of what? Of Ghassan. Who had just got preparing what to come attack what? Al-Madinah. فَإِذَا فِيهِ أَمَّا بَعْدِ. And when I opened the letter, it read the things. And to proceed. فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ بَلَغَنِي أَنَّ صَاحِبَكَ قَدْ جَفَاكَ. I heard that your companion, referring to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, that he what? He boycotted you. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلَكَ اللَّهُ بِدَارِ هَوَانٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not leave you in a place where you are going to be humiliated. وَلَا مَضْيَعَ nor left without support. فَالْحَقْ بِنَا نِوَاسِكَ. Join us and we'll give you all the support. فَقُلْتُ لَمَّا قَرَأْتَ. And I said to myself when I read it, وَهَذِهِ أَيْضًا مِنَ الْبَلَاءِ. This is another test. فَتَيَمَّمْتُ بِهَا التَّنُّورِ فَسَجَّرْتُهُ بِهَا. And then I went to my oven or furnace and I threw it what? Inside the fire. حَتَّى إِذَا مَضَتْ أَرْبَعُونَ لَيْلَةً. To the end of the story. What? See? Why, يا أخوة? Symbol. We are Muslims. First, our feelings, and I insist on the word feelings, are controlled submissively by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in following His religion. Second, we have to wish the best for everyone, including the enemy who hates you for no reason except that you say, La ilaha illallah. When they fight, we fight very bravely. And when there is no need to fight, we do not fight, and nobody knows about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and nobody cares about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And nationalism is nothing but what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what? دعوها فإنها ممتنة. Said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nationalism, throw it away, for it stinks. It stinks. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.